bit about this documentary.
Well, this is a story about our fathers. We're cousins. And our fathers together for about 60 years have been writing a lot of songs for Disney movies, Disneyland, movies elsewhere, plays, commercials, TV shows, every place.
And as we were growing up, we realized a lot of people know all our dad's music, but nobody knows our dads. And our dads were extremely dimensional people that had tremendous individual and then collective careers. So we wanted to highlight that, and we decided to make a movie about it.
Are there any personal memories from working with your dad and uncle that are shown in this film?
Personal memories? Yes. There's one moment in the film, which I don't want to give away too much, but they were working on Mary Poppins. And when I was a little boy, even younger than you, I came home from school, and my dad was having trouble, and his dad were having trouble coming up with an idea for a song. And I had just had this thing called the Salk vaccine, which was a polio vaccine. And my dad said, did they give you a shot? Did it hurt? And I said, no. They put it on a lump of sugar and put it on a spoon, and I ate it. And he went back with his father, and they wrote the song, A Spoonful of Sugar Helps the Medicine Go Down.
Doing the series of interviews we did, I got to know my uncle, which I didn't growing up. So that was a really exciting thing for me.
What were the challenges of making this film?
There were many challenges, and I think the most important one was to try and find the balance, not only between the two men and their stories, but the balance between how much music we would have and how many movies we would show and what music we wouldn't show, because they wrote over 1,000 songs. They did 50 movies. So where do you cut things out? They're all like children, you know, so that was a little challenging, to say the least.
I would say the same thing.
I'm speaking with Mr. Sherman. You decided to live your life by communicating through music. What do you want people to take from this movie?
Well, I think the fact that two brothers who were totally different people got together and had a great time writing songs to make people happy. I think that's a very special thing, and we had a great deal of luck and a great deal of joy in our lifetime together writing songs. And it gave us a great outlet, you know, it was a great feeling of accomplishment. And when people tell us they love our stuff and they've enjoyed it all these years, it's very gratifying. No words can describe that.
What is the most challenging thing about working with family?
Well, I think you have to overcome like sibling rivalry. You have to respect the other person. And it takes a while. It's a little hard work, you know, but eventually it paid off for Bob and myself.
Go to Disneyland to hear the songs you made for the rides?
You betcha. I absolutely. I love going to the Disneyland. I love all the rides there, and the ones that we rode particularly, of course. We go to Small World and Tiki Room and the Carousel of Progress and all that. Yes, we do.
What projects are you working on?
What?
Are you working on any new songs?
Oh, yes, I'm always working on new projects, but until they actually come out, I don't like to talk about them. But I do have a couple of things working right now, legitimate plays, actually. We have two plays that are running all over the country now, Chitty Bang Bang, Chitty Chitty Bang Bang, and Mary Poppins. They're both playing in theaters all around the country, and they'll be playing in Southern California this year. And I have a couple of other projects that I'm very much involved in.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.